With the sensationalized headlines, it's hard to really know what's going on in the real estate market. If you are a Milton homeowner or looking to become one, stay with us for the next few minutes as we share with you what is actually happening in the Milton real estate market.
December 2022 saw the average overall price for a Milton home decrease marginally over November to $1,069,000. And the median price, which many look to for a more accurate reading on the market, taking our extremes at the high and the low ends of the market, dipped 3.4% in the month of December.
The average property days on market increased for the month of December and is currently sitting at 47 days from a list to a successful home sale. The months of inventory is, however, sitting flat at 1.5 months.
We are seeing an intense surge of buyers out into the market looking at the limited supply. We only had 66 new properties come to the market in Milton last month. Now, to put that into perspective, that was even lower than at the peak of the first wave of the pandemic when we were all locked in our homes. Limited options can often breed competition, and we are starting to see the surge of that climate again, even given the interest rate climate.
This does not, however, feel like a repeat of our previous market, as many offers are still within comparable sales figures. The good inventory will continue to get the attention it deserves, and presenting your home in the absolute best possible light should be a top priority to capitalize in this marketplace.
A new year brings new rules, and we have some major changes that were introduced by the government for 2023. The federal government's ban on new foreign ownership of residential properties became law on January 1st, essentially disallowing anyone who isn't a Canadian citizen or permanent resident from buying residential real estate for 2 years.
There are a number of exemptions, though, some of which include international students who meet certain requirements, including having spent the bulk of the previous 5 years in Canada. They would be able to purchase a property for no more than $500,000. Workers who have worked and filed tax returns in Canada for the last 3 out of 4 years prior to purchasing a property, buildings containing more than 3 dwelling units and recreational properties such as cottages, cabins, and other vacation homes will also be exempt. The penalty if a non-Canadian is found guilty of contravening the act are subject to a fine of not more than $10,000. If the federal government orders the sale of the property, the non-Canadian buyer won't receive more than the amount paid for the property.
This will not significantly impact affordability by removing buyers from the market. Data from Canadian Housing Statistics Program indicates that non-residents make up less than 4% of residential property owners in most parts of the country, including Ontario and British Columbia.
Another change was the anti-flip tax effective January 1st. Canada Revenue Agency brought in an anti-flipping home tax. The CRA has already been investigating and enforcing residential real estate that was being flipped and not correctly reported as business income. There are some house flippers that have been using the primary residence exemption, so saying that they lived in the home, to claim the personal residence exemption.
As of January 1st, under the new tax law, anyone who sells a property which they own for less than 365 days will be considered to have flipped the house, and any profits from the transaction will be taxed as business income. This means the gain less any associated expenses will be fully taxable in the year of the sale, just like money earned in other employment. There are exceptions, including a death, an addition to the household, divorce, or any threat to personal safety, and more, which we will link to in the blog. Since every situation can be different, we would encourage you to speak directly with your accountant regarding your specific situation.
Also, a vacant home tax came into play. They must submit a declaration of their property's 2022 occupancy status by February 2nd of this year, so it does not include Milton yet. Halton will likely have a similar tax implemented this year. We've included a link on our blog to where you can read more about it. In Toronto, the vacant home tax is 1% of the current value assessment and will be imposed on all Toronto residences that are declared, deemed, or determined vacant for more than 6 months during the previous year. For example, if the CVA of your property is $1 million, the tax amount billed would be $10,000. The tax is based on the property's occupancy status for the previous year. For example, if the home was vacant in 2022, the tax will become payable in 2023. A full explanation of how it works, including the exemptions and requirements, can be found on the toronto.ca website, and we'll leave a link to that in our blog at sbrec.ca. If you are a Milton or Halton resident, it may be a good time to familiarize yourself with this tax, as it's likely coming down the pipe for all Halton residents in 2023.
Lots of changes and lots happening in the Canadian real estate space. We look forward to providing you with updates regularly. Like and share this video with someone, and be sure to subscribe so you don't miss out on any of our other videos.